हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम एनके जैन फ्रॉम स्किल ऑन टेक। टुडे वी विल लर्न सिंप्लीफाइड वेलोसिटी ट्रायंगल एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप्स। द टॉपिक इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड वी फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाइल रीडिंग इंजीनियरिंग बुक्स। देयरफॉर दिस विल बिकम वेरी हेल्पफुल टू इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड वर्किंग प्रोफेशनल्स दैट हाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ वेलोसिटी ट्राइंगल वी कैन कैलकुलेट मैनोमेट्रिक हेड डेवलप्ड बाई सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप। प्लीज सी द कंप्लीट वीडियो बिकॉज इट इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस डिफिकल्ट टॉपिक। इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल एंड शेयर वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स एंड कुलीग्स। General construction of a centrifugal pump. Two pictures are given of a volute casing and impeller. Here you can see what centrifugal pump contains. This is inlet of a centrifugal pump and this is discharge of a centrifugal pump, which is called outlet nozzle for outgoing of the fluid. Here you can see a impeller is shown and these are the backward curved vanes mounted on the impeller. This rotor assembly transferring energy to fluid, imparting centrifugal force to incoming fluid at center. And this is a volute casing. What you can see, the area of volute casing is increasing. This area is getting increased. So this convert the kinetic energy of liquid into a pressure energy at the discharge. If we install a pressure gauge at discharge nozzle of the pump, you can see what is the head developed by a centrifugal pump. What is the manometric head developed by a centrifugal pump. This complete action is due to centrifugal force generated by a impeller. What are the fluid flow equations? The fluid flow equations are given by Bernoulli, great scientist Bernoulli. So first we will understand a continuity equation, because these equations are applied on flowing liquids. So what is continuity equation? A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. Here A1 is a area of a pipeline at one point and V1 is a velocity of a liquid at one point. And A2 is a area of a pipeline at another point, point number 2. And V2 is velocity of a liquid at point number 2. Bernoulli equation. Energy of a liquid flowing in a pipeline remain constant at two points. So what is that? P plus half mv square plus mgh equal to constant, where P is a pressure energy, half mv square is a kinetic energy and mgh is a potential energy. While applying a Bernoulli equation at two points, we will consider frictional losses of a pipeline also. What is a velocity diagram? As we know, when liquid enters into a centrifugal pump impeller, it have two velocities. One is a velocity of liquid and other one is a velocity of impeller. So that velocities are represented by a velocity diagrams. So velocity diagram of pump is a representation of various velocities of pump impeller and liquid handled. The velocities of both liquid and impeller interact and kinetic energy of impeller is transferred to liquid. This velocity diagram is used to evaluate what is the work done by impeller to develop manometric head to the liquid. Concept of relative velocity. When we are standing at a point and seeing a moving train, what we will observe? Because we are a stationary observer, we will see a absolute velocity of the train. But when we are sitting in a train also and seeing a moving train, then we will have a relative system. The velocity of both the trains will become relative to each other. Here, in the velocity diagrams, fluid is moving on the impeller. So, fluid is having its own velocity and impeller is having its own velocity. But the velocity which will come out of the impeller become relative, because both the velocities are interacting to each other. So we will see a resultant velocity of fluid that will be called resultant velocity. Here you can see in this picture that Q is a flow and this W is a flow velocity. And u is a velocity of impeller here. So what will be the tangential velocity of impeller? It will be r omega. And what will be q? The flow will equal to c into a. C is a absolute velocity of liquid entering into the impeller. Area of impeller equal to 2 pi rb, where b is a impeller width. So we can calculate total flow going on through impeller. U is a flow rate. Velocity vector diagram of a typical centrifugal pump. A picture of an impeller is given. So here we can see this is an inlet blade and this is an outlet blade of an impeller. There are two velocities. One is velocity of liquid entering into the impeller and other one is a impeller velocity. So let us see this inlet velocity triangle. Here you can see this is an absolute velocity at inlet of impeller and this W1 is a relative velocity of liquid entering into the impeller, flowing into the impeller. And U1 is a tangential velocity of impeller at inlet. R1 is a impeller inlet radius, R2 is a impeller outlet radius. Beta1 and beta2, this beta1, this is a blade angle with tangential velocity at inlet and beta 2 is a blade angle with outlet tangential velocity. This one. Now we can see at outlet velocity triangle, C2 is a absolute velocity at outlet of liquid. W2 is a relative velocity of outlet at liquid. This C2 will have two components. One is a horizontal component Cu2, which is called real velocity of liquid at outlet, and Cm2 is a velocity of flow. The real velocity at inlet will become zero as this is entering axially 90 degree at inlet. So real velocity at inlet will be zero. Omega is equal to 2 pi n upon 60. Omega is angular speed of the impeller. So let us understand this velocity triangle, how we will calculate the work done by a impeller. We have seen velocity diagram. If W1 is relative velocity of liquid entering and U1 is impeller tangential velocity at inlet, then absolute velocity of liquid shall be C1 at inlet. The real velocity CU1 at inlet shall be 0 as liquid entering axially at 90 degree to the impeller as we have discussed. If W2 is relative velocity of liquid at outlet, U2 is tangential velocity of impeller at outlet, hence C2 is absolute velocity of liquid at outlet. Here CU2 and CM2 will be real and radial component of fluid outlet velocity. Beta1 and beta2 are blade angle with the tangent to vane radius at inlet and outlet respectively. Impeller force balance. You can see a picture of impeller and forces, how these are balanced. For the circular system, the forces due to the pressure for both the outer and the inner periphery of the impeller as well as the radial component of the impulse forces CM1 and CM2, this and this, cancel each other out, because for each vector an equal force but of opposite direction act on the opposite half of the impeller. So these forces cancel to each other and impeller force is balanced. Torque calculation. Let us calculate the torque applied on the liquid. The water entering the impeller per second at the inner periphery possesses the tangential momentum rho q cu1. Here, similarly, the water leaving the impeller at the outer periphery possesses the momentum rho q cu2. If tangential momentum is multiplied by radius, a moment of momentum is obtained as rho q cur. The rate of change of moment of momentum between inner and outer periphery is equal to the torque applied on the pump shaft. So let us calculate torque. Torque equal to tau equal to rho q bracket cu2r2 minus cu1 R1. Power calculation. So let us calculate how much power is transferred to the liquid. P equal to tau omega, means torque into angular speed, equal to rho q cu2 r2 omega minus cu1 r1 omega. As we know tangential velocity equal to omega r, so power equal to rho q cu2 u2 minus cu1 u1. Also, power is work done per second, rate of doing work. Since the pump is designed to lift a mass of fluid through the pump head h, the power of machine can also be expressed by power equal to mgh upon dt. So this we can write rho v, mass equal to rho v gh upon dt equal to rho q gh. As we know, flow equal to v upon dt, or power equal to rho q hm upon 75. If rho is density, q is in meter cube per second, then manometric head hm in meter, then power can be calculated in horsepower. Head and efficiency calculations. P equal to rho q g h e. H is Euler head, equal to rho q bracket cu2 u2 minus cu1 u1 bracket close. So Euler head equal to h equal to cu2 u2 minus cu1 u1 upon g. For single stage pumps, at inlet flow is radial, hence CU1 equal to 0. The real velocity at inlet will become 0. This gives Euler head equal to CU2 U2 upon G, ignoring all the losses. Manometric head is measured as HM. Hence, manometric efficiency N0 equal to HM upon Euler head equal to GHM upon CU2 U2. The difference in total head across the pump is always less than the Euler head because of the energy dissipated in eddies due to friction at impeller and casing. As we know, some of the energy will be lost in eddies inside of impeller. Therefore, the manometric head, which is measured at the discharge of the pump, is always less than the Euler head, which is developed by the impeller. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below and share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.